way helpful for the men of this age. That is recommended in Bhagavatam. Now either you adopt this yoga or that yoga according to your capacity. But you must have to perform yoga. Without yoga you cannot be happy. Yajna sista sino santa mucchante sarvakim sai bhunyante te aghang papa je pachanti atmakaranat. Now, pachanti atmakarana means cooking. The cooking is the most important business of our life. Cooking, nobody is human being. We are not cats and dogs. And every human being has to cook things for eating. Now this eating process, the Lord says that one who takes the eatables after the sacrifice, then he becomes free from all kinds of sinful reactions. And one who cooks for himself, for enjoyment, then he eats all kinds of sins. All kinds of sins. Jagga sista sina santa. Santa. Santa means saints and sages. They do not take anything without offering jagga. At least whenever you take something, if you offer the same thing to the Lord, my Lord, it is by your grace I have got this eatable. You kindly accept it and I shall take the remnants. This is yoga. This is also yoga. So just yesterday we prepared some food cooperatively and offered to Lord and performed sankirtan and we took it. This is the simplest process of performing yoga. Because we require food. So this was done here in this loft as a matter of example. But you can do it in your home also. Because you are cooking for your children, for yourself, for your wife, for family members. Now if you cook nicely things which are to be offered to the Lord, of course we must be careful to prepare foodstuffs. Because we are going to offer to the Lord and we must offer things which is acceptable by the Lord. At least. Of course, Lord can accept anything and everything. He is quite competent. Because all powerful, almighty. But still, in the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, the Lord says, Patram Puspam Phalam Tuyam Jumi Bhakta Prajacchati. Anyone who gives me these four things, patram, puspam, phalam, toyam. That means grains, vegetables, and flowers, fruits, all these things, anyone who offers me, I take them. Offers with taya bhakta uparitam, with devotion. Not that God is hungry and therefore he is hankering after your offering of foodstuff. Know that. He is quite competent. He has got many things to eat. It is practically his things we are eating. But still, if we prepare foodstuff in that way and offer to the Supreme Lord, then after offering if we take, then we become free from all sinful reactions. That is stated here, Jagga Sista Sino Santa Muchyante. Muchyante means he becomes liberated, freed from. What is that? Sarva Kilmi Sai, all kinds of sinful reactions. That's all. But one who does not do so, Bhunjante Te Aghang Papa, they must be eating only sins. Only sins. So we have to suffer the sinful reaction also. Je pachyante atmakarana. Now the thing is, now it is very easy. What? You are going to the store, just like yesterday, a day before yesterday, Mr. Carl and Mr. Paul went to some store. Oh, tomorrow it will be jagga. The bad things are purchased with the purpose of perfume. The same thing we are purchasing from the store, but we are thinking, I sell it. That if you transfer that epithet only, that this is, we are purchasing things for God's eating. So there is no loss on your part, but you perform jagga. You perform jagga. This practice has to be done. Jagga sista sino santa mucchante sarvikimasi. If you practice these simple things, then you become free from all sinful reaction. And if you don't do this, then what happens? Na bhunjante te adhang papa. One who does not do this, he eats only sinful reaction and he has to pay for that. He has to suffer for that. Pachanti atmakarma. He has no relation with the jagga or Vishnu. But he thinks that I shall eat. So the beginning of the process of jagga in this age can be very easily done by everyone, either he is family man or single man or any. Everyone has to cook for himself. Now that cooking may be done for the Supreme Lord, and after cooking the foodstuff, offer it to the Supreme Lord and perform this jagga, sankirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Then you become free from all sinful. After all, whatever we are doing, we are committing some sort of, even unknowingly. There are recommendations in these Vedas, Pancha Jagga. Pancha Jagga means that unknowingly we are killing many living entities. Suppose you are, when you are walking on the street, there are many ants who are being killed on the pressure of our shoes. So that is also counted as sin. In God's kingdom, in God's, I mean to say, state, just like here, you have to pay by your life if you kill one man. If you commit a murder, you have to repay this murdering sin by your own life. That is, of course, an imperfect law, man-made law. Similarly, in God's law also, if you kill any living entity, you have to suffer for that. Because in the God's eyes, there is no question of man or animal or ant or fly or something. Every living entity is the son of God. Now suppose your father has got 5 sons. One of them is worthless, is doing nothing. And if the other son says, my dear father, this son, your youngest son or this son is worthless, is doing nothing, let us kill him. Will your father agree? Because he is worthless, will your father agree? No. He will say, no, you have nothing to do. He is not harming you, he is eating my subsistence, I am paying for his subsistence, why you should kill him? Similarly, in this material nature, all these living entities in different forms, they have come for material enjoyment, and everything is being supplied by the Supreme Lord. We have no right to kill them, we have no right. According to God's law, if one is conscious, the same thing, just like the father will never agree to kill a worthless child by the competent boy. No. So, consciously or unconsciously, we are committing, suppose I am not willingly killing any animal, but unconsciously I am killing so many living entities. By my walking, by my so many things, they are called pancha jaggas in the Vedic. So, and even if we can do not kill animals, simply by eating vegetables. They are also life. It does not mean that vegetarians are not killing. They are also killing. The law is that a living entity lives by killing other living entity. That is the law. Those who have got hands, they are killing those who have got legs. Just like man is killing animal. The animal is eating the grass, those who have no legs. So this is the law. But our thing is that we have to offer yajna. Killing of animals does not mean that if a man kills a cow or goat for eating, he is killing. And those who are vegetarian, they are not killing, they are also killing. Because vegetable has also got life. So it is not the question of killing. It is the question of offering yajna. It is the question of offering yajna. Even animal eaters and the flesh eaters, they have also some process for offering yajna. In the Vedic process, even the flesh eaters, they are also prescribed that you can perform yajna like this. The yajna must be there. Yajna must be there. But so far we are concerned who are going to have Krishna consciousness. We have to take the instruction of Krishna as he says in the Bhagavad Gita. He says that patram pushpam phalam tuyam. He is asking foodstuff prepared from vegetable kingdom. Therefore, we have to prepare things from vegetable kingdom nicely and very palatably and offer Krishna and then take it. This yajna will make us free from all kinds of sins and our life will be.